Hi guys, this is Mina Devan and you're watching HealthSite and India.com. Today we have with us Dr. Sanjeev Sasidharan, Head of Critical Care, SL Raheja Hospital. Hi doctor, how are you?
Hi.
So the very first question that comes to my mind right now is the talk of the town presently, the Omicron strain of COVID-19 virus. Firstly, what is this Omicron variant and why is it so dangerous at this point?
Well, the emergence of yet another virus variant is definitely of concern in COVID, and it's a wake-up call for all of us. And this variant of concern that we have just been designated to two days ago is a variant that has got an unprecedented and an unusual constellation of mutations. There are up to more than 50 mutations in this particular virus, and just to put this in perspective, Delta had 3 and Beta had 2. So there are more than 50 mutations here, and out of which 30 are there on the most important parts, as the spike protein, which is responsible for, you know, the vaccine targets, as well as there are around 10 to 15 mutations on something called a receptor binding domain, which is very, very important in the fight against the virus. So that's why this becomes a little bit more significant.
But what are the symptoms of this variant and how is it different from any other variant or for that matter, Delta?
So it's too early to comment as of now as to what would be the difference in the symptoms. And, you know, to put again matters into perspective, there was a WhatsApp or a video that came out of a doctor from South Africa who said that the amount of the symptoms are very less, but the WHO has definitely exercised caution on this, and it's far too early to comment on the symptoms. I presume that since this is a variant of the COVID-19, we are still going to have disease-related symptoms. And as we've seen over a period of last couple of months, the symptoms have moved from a little bit of fever to breathlessness to more of weakness. So I presume, looking at that variation, we probably see more of weaknesses and breathlessness coming up. I presume, but we are too early to comment on this per se.
Also, where did this variant actually originate from? How did it evolve suddenly?
So, very good question, Mini. So what really occurs here is that what is important for the lay public to understand is if the virus gets a host, it will spread. If it gets a host, it will spread. And the likely hosts that we have are patients who are immunocompromised, patients with hepatitis, patients with HIV, patients who have high-risk conditions that could make the virus stay in them. And you must understand, if the virus gains entry, it is going to mutate sometime or the other. So more the mutations, more the problems is what we generally expect in these cases, in these kind of patients. So that's why if you look at South Africa, this has come in from South Africa in a patient which they have indexed as a patient who was immunocompromised, who was HIV, probably was unable to ward off that particular virus, and that is the reason the virus actually gained a foothold and mutated and now is spreading all around the place. And this is very important for me to state here that South Africa is only around 30-35% vaccinated. So that is the reason that the virus has actually got a foothold there.
Also, sir, it said that this particular strain of virus is 6 times more transmissible than Delta, and it could even affect the vaccinated. So is it true?
Yeah, so among the mutations that we talk about in this particular Omicron, there are a few mutations that have known to increase the transmissibility. That is for certain. There are a few mutations that are known to increase transmissibility. At the same time, there are a few mutations that could help the vaccine to evade the virus to evade vaccine related immunity. But notwithstanding, it's important for us to understand the same situation occurred even with Beta variant. In the Beta variant also, there was a couple of mutations which actually would help the virus to evade vaccine immunity. But what we noticed was something different. What we noticed was even then, the vaccine-related immunity prevented patients from getting rather sick and prevented them from getting into the hospital. So it definitely has less strain on the environment and as for that particular individual patient too.
Also, a lot of countries have already imposed travel bans. So which are the countries that have already detected the Omicron strain of virus?
Right. So there are up to 12 countries that have actually detected the Omicron variant, and this is in a span of 5 days. You must understand that on 24th of November is when the WHO actually called this a variant of concern. This was first seen on 9th of November in a patient in South Africa. So within four or five odd days, we've basically seen it going to 12 countries. But that has been the scene even with Delta. In Delta, we had, once Delta was actually recognized as a variant of concern, there were 53 countries in 3 weeks. So it's nothing new on this regard. So it is something we know, it is transmissible, and it is definitely looking more transmissible than the Delta virus.
And what's the situation currently in India, and what's expected in terms of this strain in India, the effect of this strain in India?
So at the moment, there is no documented case of this particular virus entering into India. However, let me be clear about this, because this virus can only be detected if you do a genomic sequencing. So for all that you know, the virus may have already entered into India and we're just not able to detect it. So the usual RT-PCR test will detect SARS-CoV-2, but it may not detect Omicron, the usual RT-PCR that we are taking. So if for all practical reasons, it would have already entered India is what I feel. And travel bans are not the answer, because there are other ways that the virus can enter inside. The virus can enter inside through supply chain. I mean, it is just not a travel ban would never really cause a stemming of the entire epidemic. In fact, the only thing that you can do now is you have weapons. You have got masks, you have got social distancing, we've got hand wash, hand hygiene, and preventing crowded spaces. This will probably prevent it, and of course, vaccination. That will prevent it.
Also, doctor, so what's the way out now? Are there any medicines being worked on? Is there any treatment process that's being worked on?
Well, there is a beacon of hope here. There are two major medicines coming into the market, both being oral pills. One is called as molnupiravir, and the other is called as Paxlovid. Both of them have been applied for the US FDA approval. Very soon, in a month or 2 months' time, we should see it entering into the Indian markets. Now, this particular Paxlovid is something that will probably take care of variant of concerns also, by the looks of it, because it actually targets a very early replication phase of the virus. So it really does not, it may work in the variants of concern is what we feel. And that's one ray of hope. And in the last 20 odd months of in the pandemic, we've seen most of the investigation going in lightning phase, and very soon we'll know whether the monoclonal antibodies that we have will also work against this particular variant of concern. But at the end of the day, the way out is by what we've been doing, good housekeeping. That means masking, not visiting crowded spaces, at the same time vaccinating a large proportion. One of the most important things that we need to understand is also the fact that we need to have good equitable distribution of vaccination. By equitable distribution, it means each and every country in the world should have a good proportion of individuals that are vaccinated. What we must understand is, if there is vaccination, the viruses will not get a new host, hence it will not mutate. If we do not get this vaccination done right, we will see this pandemic going on for ages and ages and years after years. So that is the reason that vaccination would be the key here, and that is the reason that also booster doses is something that probably make a lot of sense here.
So is it time for people to get their booster shots done, even if they are double vaccinated?
Yeah, so on a biological plausibility, what you must understand is, after 6 or 7 odd months, the immunity that we gain from vaccination actually starts waning. That we all know, it starts waning. And there have been studies that also talks about 3 to 4 months of waning immunity in patients who've been in individuals who've been vaccinated. Now, these vaccines, there are two targets, the S1 and the S2 target of these particular viruses. The vaccine actually targets the S2, and the S2 is very common among all the SARS-CoV-2s. It is the S1 that really mutates very bad, very, very horribly. And what really occurs now is that this vaccine will give you a broad-based immunity. It will give you a broad-based immunity. And as I told you, vaccine is not to kill the virus. It is to prevent you from getting into the hospital or preventing you from getting rather sick. So it will do that job, is what we all feel.
Okay. So, any other tips or any other advice that people who are listening right now should follow?
So it's been a good 20 months on the pandemic, and we as healthcare workers are really fighting it out even now. We do not want the repeat of the Delta coming back. We don't want that repeat of that kind of a wave coming back here. And the only way that we can do it is by our existing weapons. And forget all this else. Our existing weapons is masking, is ensuring that you don't go to crowded spaces. It's a little bit, just a little bit of help that we require from each and every situation of a person over there in the country. And try to get as many as people vaccinated. Try and get as many as people vaccinated, and that is how we can all together stop this pandemic from spreading and losing a lot of our near and dear ones.
That's true. So keep your masks on. Please, please, please don't go in crowded spaces. And let's, together fight this pandemic. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining today, Doctor. It has been fab. Thank you so much. Audiences will surely go back home with lots of valuable insights. So thank you for that.
Welcome. Bye.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.